If you haven't got £30,000 for a BMW M2, consider an Alfa GT for £1,500. Comes with free McDonald's. No, in all seriousness, it's got about half the horsepower, but it's twice the fun.
That's a £28,500 saving.
Yeah, what would you take? This Alfa and £28,500 in the boot, in cash, or the Beamer and no money in the boot?
Alfa in cash.
Just drop your check in. Review cars, they do this thing on the door where they have the camera like there, and then they shut the door. Ready?
No, it's meant to make a noise.
What, like?
Like when you close it. Yeah.
Alright. Sounds like a canal boat. Actually, it doesn't. It sounds like some sort of diesel tractor, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Mate, it's fast though. It's not a bad car. Especially if you've only got like 1500 quid. Like, go and get one of these. It's only done 97,000 miles. Look at that car. Is that it?
What is it?
It's a bit loud.
Yeah, but you don't. Have they discontinued Alfa Romeos?
No.
I never see it on the roads.
They're different now. But no, you would see them. They meant like little hatchbacks.
I'm not sure like anyone buys them anymore.
Jesus. People avoid Alphas if they can.
If they can. Avoid it if you can. If you can't, just start with it.
But
Oh, get a Civic, that's what I say.
This is better than a nice. Civic.
Nah.
It's stopped making that coil spring noise now. Just get up on over some bumps, doesn't seem to be making it.
Hair is not a problem. What are you?
Look, no one else going right, so let's go right anyway. Yeah, what is that? That's a Triumph TR7. That's quite a cool car.
What is that?
It's a wheel spin. Mate, that's 40. 50.
Really?
60. 70.
That's faster than that.
Bloody hell! That's not, that is more than enough power for someone. Like, yeah, just pass your test and you want a £1,500 car.
Yeah.
You've got leather seats. You got a cup holder. Mate.
Coin holder as well.
Coin holder.
Is it old school? It's got a cigarette lighter.
Yeah, an air balloon. There you go. Nah,
use that as an FM
car.
Transmitter.
It's got a radio.
This is the engine that comes in the Vauxhall, 1.9 diesel of 150 horsepower. A lot of them are just 120, but if you look at enough of them, you'll see that some of them come with the 150 brake. But James, he managed to squeeze nearly 300 out of his 1.9 150 just by putting like a turbo on it and a remap. I think you had to do something with the swell flap, maybe it's called a swell flap delete or something. But it was like, that's a lot of torque, isn't it?
Yeah.
How does this compare to your C3?
Yeah.
Faster?
I'd say it's faster than the C3. I feel like a lot of cars were faster than the C3. Actually, not true.
No.
The Corsa was pretty slow.
But even on these roads, like, it handles so well. Like,
yeah.
Damp country roads, it's like, awesome. I love our B-Tech review. Whoa, bit of wheel spin. Great track car, this would. You could take this round Goodwood easily. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
What is this about? What's this exhaust? and sneak on the track. They're definitely not going to let us on, but if you hold the camera, I will try and sneak on.
You have to go through scrutineering, and you have to get your sound testing done. There's that Quattro Sport again. What's he doing? He's not even driving. He's coming today. No, we can't get on. Can't be asked. Quite a good turning circle.
Mm-hmm. Oh, oh, mate, you've hit that. What?
No way. You got that. Unreal.
I thought I worked out the codes, but it didn't work.
It's got, it, to be fair, I really like the way the swing drives. Like, it's a very cool car, if you know what I mean. Like, look at this Mini in front. Would you rather be in this than that?
Was that, well, that was on a track? No, it wasn't.
I don't know, it's terrible weather. It was. On some country roads. Pulls really well for 150 horsepower.
Yeah.
That's 60 already. Good brakes. Mate! That is pretty decent. Oh, yeah. Temperature's alright. Everything's just like, doesn't. It wouldn't go wrong if you had this. This is what I'm saying. You bought a 1500 quid track car. Like, no worries. Third gear. That is 60, 70. Can't even say what we're doing now, but that's quite hard. Whoa! Yeah, I think I'd get in a bit of trouble if I had one of these. What do you like about the Alfa Romeo, Kev?
I don't know, I mean it's got its... Yeah, it's nice leather seats. It's quite old school.
It is old school.
That's what's appealing about it. It's got a gear stick that works, six gears.
Yeah,
it's pretty quick. Oh my days, mate.
There was a dip in the road, I had to avoid it.
Hmm.
Yes.
Yeah, it looks good. The old town of Arundel.
Alfa Romeo in Arundel, Italy.
It was really weird. The lights are flashing on here.
Really?
Yeah, look.
Hey, Arundel's nice.
Norfolk Arms. This is where ABBA perform, actually.
Oh yeah, it is, isn't it?
Every August
another
they come here.
Feature of the Alfa Romeo are the windscreen wipers. Ready? Oh. Bit sporadic.
Yeah. Dog. Get some water on it.
To be fair, you get used to the diesel noise. It doesn't sound like that.
I didn't really clock it, to be honest. I don't feel like it's much noisier than any other car.
Definitely is. No, you're right, it's not like that.
It's weird that,
I don't know what he's doing.
Wrong side. Just doing loops now. Gunch, go straight in.
And then you just tap the horn twice.
Let us in. Does it not work?
Okay, the horn don't work. Oh, there we go. They're not going to let us in, are they? I mean, that noise is really irritating when you're in reverse. I can't concentrate on reverse.
I know, it's so loud. It just needs a beginning. Where's it even? It sounds like it comes up from the back as well.
Disconnect the sounder on that, I think.
The initial beep is fine. It doesn't need all the rest.
No.